Hi, Nick Collier here, and this is my shop. Come join me. We'll have some fun. Okay, so here's what I'm seeing is that it took some of the tops of the threads off, but I'm seeing that it also peeled off some of the thread off of the clevis. So we might be able to come in here and find a decent thread out of this. See how it's just kind of peeling out? And there's a bit of a groove in there. So this is going to take a bit to do, but hey, it's worth it. I might actually have a thread. So I'll be back. Okay, so we've come in and we've taken an old cold chisel and I sharpened it on the side to get a sharp point on the side and a flat on the tip of the chisel so that we can get into that groove and kind of start to clean it. And it looks like it's going to do pretty good. Thing is it's hard to know what's good metal and what's not. I did just about everything I could do to figure out how to get these threads cleaned out, and I finally came up with a three-corner file. And three corners would be 100 and... what is that? Well, I think it ends up being about 60 degrees. Let me look. In fact, exactly 60 degrees. So a three-corner file is going to do it. This is going to take for fucking ever. But I got a thread, and I don't know if you can see it or not. Right in here, I filed this whole thing. And there's substantial thread there. I mean, it's not, you know, the ace thread that you can get, you know, when you could do a total machine, but this is enough to grab onto and to spin the head on and spin it back off again and put something else on if needed. Because I want to do a couple of things, more than a couple of things with this press than just push out bearings and stuff. So we're going to file this a little further and let's see how it goes. But I'm going to move you sideways a little bit here. Okay. Now just come in with that three corner and work these little grooves. So every time I push on it, of course, it wiggles the camera. I think what we're going to do is just kind of, you know, not film this part because I can't quite get it right. But we'll be back. All right, it's coming out pretty good. I'm about halfway there. It's, 45 minutes later. We're going to rotate this around again. Continue chasing the threads. Okay, we're just barely halfway, and I got about an hour in this now so far, but, you know, it's worth it. Get a good thread out of that, and I've got something that'll last me for the next, you know, 50 years. Well, if I last 50 years. So, we're going to take a break. My hands are hurting, and my eyes are kind of bugging, and it's time. So, we'll be back. Okay, so we've got the threads filed out. I can't know if it's even going to work or not, but we're going to take some measurements, and we're going to cut some threads on the lathe, and maybe we can kind of round off the root of the threads, and later on come back in with a file and file off the crown of the threads. Let's go over to the lathe, and see what we can do about boring that hole in the tip itself. All right, well, we're gonna take it to 85, and which means we've got another, I think it was 50, so we got another 30. Well, good morning, Nick Collier here again, and man, I have got some exciting news. Yesterday, I'm looking for something else totally different than this project, and I stumble upon this this old die that I found at a garage sale, I don't know, a year or so ago, and I'll be damned if it doesn't have an adjustable 1 5/8, it'll fit 1 5/8, 10 threads per inch die in it. So we're going to be able to actually thread this. Now, I'm not sure about the plug that I'm going to have for the end here because I've already boarded out the size. It may not fit anymore. I may have to get another piece of steel, but better to have good threads here and you know, chuck that piece. So I'll be back. We'll figure this one out. All right, so we've got the die. We're gonna put it on here, and it looks like it's gonna be just about right, just enough to kind of get on there a little bit so that we can see how it's gonna go. And this is definitely going to take some effort to get this in there square. There it was. That looks pretty square. It's starting to cut. Looks like it's off. Oh yeah, this jumped. All right, so we can't get it off. Okay, we're gonna take this off and do it again because it looks like my die moved up. How, I don't know, but it did. Well, it's loose, that's how. All right, let's give that a try. There it goes. I think that's straight. We're going to take some measurements and make sure. All We're just gonna be able to eyeball it because I can't really get in there. That looks good. And that looks good. All right, I think we're straight. So now it's just a matter of, we're gonna have to put our big ass wrench on there. Going. I do see one problem though. And that is these are too tall for the wrench to be in there. So I'm going to cut these off with a hacksaw just right here on the spot so I don't have to start this thing again. And let's see how it goes. Okay, well, this is going to be a slow process, but certainly worth doing. Okay, so now we want to take the bar out. Turn our head around. Put the bar back in. Yeah, we're actually getting a good thread there. We got a ways to go, but it's pulling a good thread. So, continuing. We'll come back after a while. Okay, you can see that totally macked up thread really cleaned up nicely. So what we're going to do now is we're going to turn the die around because it cleaned it up from down in these last five or six threads, but this upper part up in there is not cleaned up. So we're going to turn the die around and run it in backwards so that it has a chance to clean up the upper threads too.
So, we'll be back.
Okay, as you may or may not know, it's almost impossible to get a regular die to go in backwards. And this two-piece die is, you know, 10 times worse. So I had to set up a platform and then let the ram slide down and put my head on top of the platform so it would be level. And so then it started to take just a little bit. And now I'm about four threads in and it's looking pretty good. So we're going to keep going because we've got these from this point on. We've got to cut a bunch of threads, and it's going to be nip and tuck, I'm sure. Well, we're not quite there yet because obviously it's going easy. Now it's starting to grab into those boogered up threads. But it feels like it's cutting pretty easy. Still. All right, we got ourselves a thread. Not the best thread in the world, but certainly a usable one. All right, let's drop that first. Bring this back up. Put our retainer in there. That's a nice looking thread for what we started with. And we'll be back. Okay, so we fixed the threads, which is great because now we have some really good clean threads. But, you know, I found this thing yesterday afternoon, and yesterday morning, of course, I bored this out about 30 thousandths too big. So I was thinking, well, okay, let's just get a new piece of metal. Well, wait a second. We can just bore that out and sleeve it and then bore it out again. And I found a piece of 8620, so it would be a good fit. Bore this out, sleeve it, bore that out, and thread that part. So I think that's what we're going to do. And hey. Well, I'll tell you, I'm sure glad that I'm not working, you know, trying to make money on this project, because I would have lost my ass a long time ago. But, you know, this is just kind of fun stuff that I'm doing, you know, whenever I can, whenever I have the extra room and or the extra time. And, you know, one step after another. Let's get a little oil on my ways. There we go. So we need to go. We are now at something 50, 1385, and we want to go to, oh, I don't know. We may need to be a bit bigger than that. Yeah, I think we're going to need to be, well, 350. Yeah, that's not enough. All right, so we're going to have to, where'd that other little plug of steel go? I found another one that had a bigger diameter. I'll be back. Yeah, that's going to give us a little bit more. So we'll have, oh, a good 3/8 on each side for the threads. Is that still going to be a little iffy? How big are our threads? There's the size of our, the outside of our threads. I don't know, that's still a little close. I don't know, it's 150 or so. Let's see if we can find a bigger piece. All right, we start with 150, and we're going up to 1350. Hang on a second, let's make sure. All right, 1450 is the outside thread diameter, and we're now at 1600. So I'll take it up another 100 or so. And we've got our plug is almost 1900. Okay, so we found ourselves a little plug of steel, and it's of course oversized, which is good. So we've got a good quarter inch to take off of that before it'll fit. So let's go ahead. Okay, that's a good start.